Hey, what is up guys? My name is Cosmin and in today's video tutorial, you'll learn how to design a character using Photoshop CC. You can follow along or just try to come up with a unique idea. As always, if you have any questions, don't hesitate to leave them in the comment section below and I'll make sure to answer them. So let's get started. You can start by looking for inspiration. I've seen this style on Pinterest, so I thought about giving it a shot. You can search for a character design or character drawing and start saving up pictures for inspiration. The idea I'm trying to create is to have a portrait of a girl that has a white hair in a summer setting with some sunglasses and maybe a hat. I've looked on Instagram since that's where you'll find girls with white hair and start building a mood board. Let's start with a simple brush and just try to define some structure lines. This time around, I didn't want to begin the video with a fully rendered sketch, but just go along with any idea that makes sense and develop it through multiple stages of revisions. If you're asking, I'm using a Wacom Intuos Pro tablet, but you can pretty much do everything with a mouse as well if you want it bad enough. With this composition, something was missing here. I honestly had no idea what to do with that space, so I've added a shape that follows along with the background one. It could be a piece of clothing, but honestly I just didn't want to have a really long neck and it looks like it balances everything out. Let's double click on the thumbnail and add a red color. Hit OK. Since most Instagram feeds have an orange teal color scheme, I did a quick Google search and found this one. So I've added it inside Photoshop and started sampling colors for each shape. You can do adjustments in the color picker toolbar, hit OK once you're happy, and move on to the next shape. Once you have your base shapes defined, you can start adding some texture. I'll start with the default brush, you can find it under Converted Legacy Tool Presets, hit OK, and once you start scrolling, you should see a folder there. Open it up and under Airbrushes, start looking for the one called Airbrush Grainy Opaque. Let's select it and start using it. Usually I'll have two layers clipped to the shape I'm working on. The first one would be for the highlights and the second one for the shadows. For the highlights, I'll sample the same color and use the screen blending mode. You can always control how strong the effect is by lowering the opacity of that layer. Something around 50% should give this a subtle enough look. If you want, you can rename the layer. And then let's create one for the shadows. As I said, for this one, the blending mode I'll use is multiply. Same color sampled, just set on multiply. This is a very basic shading technique. My goal is to give this just a bit of dimension and not look like it's been done in Illustrator. I haven't thought about a particular direction from where the light comes, even though I should, but it's probably from the right side. Adding some details can help with any character design. I'll start with some hair strays using the pen tool. You can place them wherever you want. I'll do some on the sides and probably on the neck area. Once you've drawn the path, select an empty field and set a stroke of 2 pixels. The last bit of shading will be a harsh shadow on one of the sides of her face. Using the same brush, I'll just try to block it in and see if I like the way it looks. Once I'm done with blocking it in, I'll lower the opacity of the layer a bit till I find the value I'm happy with. In the end, this is how the illustration looks. A lot of you have been asking me how to get better with sketching, so with this exercise I wanted to show you that you don't need to start with the sketch if you don't want to. Just have some inspiration next to you and start building and adjusting shapes along the way. If you want to download the illustration, you can find the link in the description below. Hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more. Till next time, take care guys, bye!